Welcome viewers in Learning for Knowledge channel. We will continue our lectures in organic chemistry. Today topic is types of carbon and hydrogen in saturated carbon, in saturated hydrocarbons. This lecture is again useful for advanced level, second year FSC, grade 12, MDCAT tests and ECAT tests. Now, in this lecture, we will describe the types of carbon atoms present in hydrocarbons. The carbon atom is unique in its nature because it makes four covalent bonds, very stable covalent bond. That's why millions of stable compounds are exist in the universe. Now, looking in the saturated hydrocarbons, when we have a carbon atom, it can be bonded with another carbon atom or with other atoms like hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, etc. Now, if this carbon present in hydrocarbon is attached with one other carbon atom, that is one of its valency satisfied with another carbon atom and rest of three valencies are satisfied with other atoms like hydrogen, then this carbon is called primary carbon and it is denoted by one knot. Because in this case, this carbon is directly bonded with this carbon and here hydrogen, here hydrogen, here hydrogen. So this is primary carbon. Now, second type is secondary carbon. Now, carbon atom attached with two other carbon atoms, that is two of its valencies are satisfied with two other carbon atoms. This is the carbon which is under consideration and we call this secondary carbon. Then it must be attached with two carbon atoms and rest of the two bonds are with other atoms like hydrogen, chlorine, etc. So this is called secondary carbon and it is denoted by two knot. Third type is tertiary carbon. Carbon atom attached with three other carbon atoms, that is three of its valencies satisfied with three carbon atoms. Now this is the carbon and you can see three valencies are satisfied with these carbon and fourth one is with hydrogen or any other atom. This is denoted by three knot. Then quaternary carbon, if this carbon is attached with four other carbon atoms, then this carbon is called quaternary carbon and denoted by four knot. These four types of carbon are present in saturated hydrocarbons. These are the examples which can looking on this, in this example you can easily understand the concept of both of four of these types. First, if we start from right to left, this carbon is primary carbon because it is attached only with one hydrogen atom. Similarly, these carbons like this one, this one, this one, which is at the terminal, so these are also called as primary carbon because these carbons are attached only with one carbon atom. Now, moving further from right to left, this carbon is attached with three carbons and only one hydrogen is attached with this carbon. So this is called tertiary carbon because three carbons are attached with this carbon. Now, moving further toward left, this carbon is attached only with these two carbon atoms, so this is secondary. And this carbon is attached with four carbon atoms, so this is called tertiary carbon. By looking the same thing in another way, like this diagram, here these are the structure diagram. Now you look on this side, this is the quaternary carbon because it is attached with these four carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is called secondary because it is connected with these two carbon atom. Secondary and the terminal carbons are always primary and this one is tertiary because it is bonded with three carbon atom. Now, like quaternary name, there are other names also for primary, secondary and tertiary. In case of primary, this is called methyl because like this is methyl group. Only one carbon is attached with this carbon, So this is primary, and we can also call it methyl. In case of secondary carbon, we can call this methylene. That is, when two hydrogens are present with the carbon and remaining two bonds are satisfied with the other carbon, this is called methylene, like secondary. And in case of tertiary, when this carbon is attached with three carbon and with one hydrogen, then this is called methine or tertiary. And quaternary, when there is no hydrogen is present. If we look this thing in a three-dimensional structure, the black balls are representing carbon and white balls representing the hydrogen. We will start from this. This is terminal carbon, a terminal part of these compound. So at the terminal, all these three carbon are called primary carbons, because these are attached with only one carbon, and rest of the bond, three bonds are satisfied with hydrogen. Third hydrogen is inside the plane, so it is not visible in this picture. Now this is secondary because it is connected with two carbon atoms and two hydrogen atoms, and this is tertiary because it is connected with three carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, and fourth one is hydrogen, which is inside the plane, which is not visible in this picture. So this is another way to describe the primary, secondary, tertiary carbons. Now similarly, types of hydrogen. So primary hydrogens, which is represented by one knot, are attached to carbons bonded to one other carbon atom. Like this is the example, if this carbon is attached with only one carbon, then rest of the three bonds are satisfied with other atoms like hydrogen. So the hydrogen present on this carbon is called primary hydrogen. Secondary hydrogens are attached to carbons bonded to two other carbons, like this one, and the maybe there is a hydrogen, then this is called secondary. And tertiary hydrogens is attached to carbon bonded to three other carbons, this one. And because when there is a quaternary carbon, no place for hydrogen, so there is no quaternary type hydrogen. So these are the primary, secondary, tertiary. And you look that the primary hydrogens are present on primary carbon, secondary hydrogens are present on secondary carbon, and tertiary hydrogen is present on tertiary carbon. These are the resemblances. Now in the future, when we look into the chemical reactions, then of the hydrocarbon, the concept of these carbons and hydrogens play a very important role, because the stability of primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary carbons are different, so they behave differently during the chemical reaction, because their stability and reactivity are different. These concepts play a very important role, especially now if there must be some MCQs in medical exam test, ECAT test, where some question may be asked by giving the structure and asking you that point out the primary hydrogen, primary carbon or secondary carbon or tertiary in a complex structure, as I shown you in the previous slides. Like maybe they will give you the structure and ask about what is this carbon. You have to write that this is the secondary or tertiary or primary or any other type. So this concept or this lecture will be useful in solving or making the concept, which will be helpful not only during the organic chemistry but also in the medical or engineering exam tests. And one other thing, I summarize three points which are very important to remember, that in open chain hydrocarbons, only primary and secondary carbon atoms are present. If there is a straight chain, no branching occur, then only two types of carbons are present, which are primary and secondary. If there are branches, then other types comes. Branch chain hydrocarbon having tertiary carbon atom are named as isohydrocarbon. That is isobutane, isopropane, isoheptane, like that. isopentane. This is the example, because this, due to this carbon atom which is tertiary, its name is isobutane. In IUPAC standard rules, the name of this compound is 2-methyl propane, but if we will consider only this tertiary carbon, we can also write this isobutane. The third one is the branch chain hydrocarbons having quaternary carbon atom are named as neohydrocarbon, like this last one. This carbon is connected with other four carbon atoms, so this is called neopentane. If we write IUPAC name, its name is 2,2-dimethyl propane. But by considering this carbon as a, you know, quaternary carbon, so its name is neopentane. These name can further be written as neopentane, new heptane, and something like that. So remember these general point, and one important thing is that in case of a straight chain, this is only, there will be only two type of carbon, which are primary at the terminals, and in the middle there will be secondary hydrocarbon. So I hope you will understand these concepts and enjoy this lecture, and we will come to you soon with other lectures which will be further detail in organic chemistry, like reactions of alkanes, alkynes, how we can prepare alkanes, alkene, alkyne, and their reactivity. So wait for next lecture. Thank you very much, and if you still not subscribe our channel, please subscribe it.